Hello, dears. It's Professor Knestor Jackdaws, and I just wanted to comment on this recent controversy surrounding the young man who passed himself off as an expert on the monarchy during the royal wedding and who effectively bamboozled the American news media. His name is Thomas J. Mace Archer Mills, with a lot of hyphens in there. You know, you should always be suspicious, first off, of someone that has any hyphens at all, and if he has two or three. I mean, that's a dead giveaway.
I'm in Sarasota at a hotel in Florida, there on the western panhandle of that easternmost and southernmost state of the United States, which is a long way of saying, here I am in Sarasota.
Well, here I am, dears, out on the Gulf of Finland, here in Russia, you see.
An early morning in the south of France, you could just hear some of the dogs waking up. You know, they're very alert here. I don't know if that's a poodle. Doesn't sound like a very throaty for a poodle.
I was called a professor from a very early age, or little prof or proffy by some of my chums.
Here's an extraordinary bit of sculpture here in this beautiful garden in Taiwan. It's a kind of, isn't it elegant? It's very, very terpsichorean, which means, that's a fancy word, which means it has something to do with the dance. Oh dear.
Typically dreary day in England. This is my old alma mater, dears. Oxmouth College, probably the most unnecessary thing possible to have to explain where I am, because this is, of course, the cynosure, or rather the centre focal point of really the American civilization.
We're at about, you know, nearly 9,000 feet, very high altitude. Sun is quite blistering. And if you've ever wanted to know what the end of civilization looks like, take a good look around. Sort of awe-inspiring sight here in San Jose is this enormous Madonna standing at least, I don't know, about 75 or 80 feet tall and wrought entirely of aluminum. You really have an experienced Taiwan, unless you've been in a busload of Taiwanese people singing karaoke.
So charmingly. Hello, Rosie Mandius, you know, the swell example, which is why I bring him with me today, is a swell example. If you use him as a symbol.
You know, it was told to me that if I wanted to attract more YouTube viewers, that I needed to be a little more, you know, outgoing, show a bit more skin. And so here I am. I hope you won't find this too offensive or prurient.
So often, the artist considers himself, and rightly so, a sort of free spirit who just paints and sculpts and writes and draws and composes, you know, whenever and wherever he wishes, and at, you know, no particular schedule. I mean, really, to some people, that's the whole point of being an artist, is getting off the clock.
We would never, for example, 25 years ago, 30 years ago, have thought about buying a bottle of water. I was just as ubiquitous as this water pouring out of this lovely fountain in this Italian villa where I'm visiting.
I think if I was a seagull, you know, I could do a lot worse for myself than to come up here to Mono Lake. And, you know, if you were if there were such a thing as a skiing seagull, why, there's so many resorts to choose from.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
One of the things that plagues people today is that it seemed like it was going to be such a convenience to have a phone on you at all times so that you could always get a message from your friend or your employer or some telemarketer. And now we realize the folly of that, don't we?
And as you can see, it has a lovely portrait of me. That's Knestor Jackdaws himself, right there on the... You can see the characteristic teeth and the round globular head and everything, and it's a very, very striking. He's 7 years old, and he's done a very, very wonderful job. In any case, he writes also, Happy Christmas, Uncle Knestor. You are the bester buster. Keep talking too much. Can I have 20 euros? I hope you don't get crabs on your toes by the seaside.
I hope you're having a wonderful season wherever you are, and I'll speak to you again soon. I'm Professor Knestor Jackdaws. Ta-ta.